Welcome to the Big Band and Swing Podcast, brought to you by SwingCityRadio.com.
There's a bright golden haze on the meadow. There's a bright golden haze on the meadow. The corn is as high as an elephant's eye, and it looks like it's climbing clear up to the sky. Oh, what a beautiful morning. Oh, what a beautiful day. I got a beautiful feeling. Everything's going my way. All the cattle are standing like statues. All the cattle are standing like statues. They don't turn their heads as they see me ride by, but a little brown maverick is winking her eye. Oh, what a beautiful morning. Oh, what a beautiful day. I got a beautiful feeling. Everything's going my way. Bright golden haze on the meadow. There's a bright golden haze on the meadow. The breeze is so busy, it don't miss a tree. And an old weeping willer is laughing at me. Oh, what a beautiful morning. Oh, what a beautiful day. I got a beautiful feeling. Everything's going my way. Oh, what a beautiful day.
Oh, What a Beautiful Morning, sung by Dick Powell. That was from a July 1943 episode of a show called Mail Call. And you know, I always seem to start the episodes off with something that jumps. But as I'm recording this, looking out the window, breezes blowing in, it is a beautiful morning. So I just thought it was appropriate. Yeah, I know, pretty tacky. But as you all know, I live in Tackyville, which just happens to share the same post office as Sarcasticsburg. So it makes for a fun podcast now, doesn't it? Well, hello there. This is the Big Band and Swing Podcast coming to you from downtown Tackyville. I'm your host, Ronaldo. I have some great music lined up for you today, including tracks from Glenn Miller, Woody Herman, Frank Sinatra, and more. We're also going to hear some fun clips from a little educational film called What to Do on a Date from 1950. In my humble opinion, it is quite a hoot, so stick around for those. But before we continue, I wanted to thank William from Minnesota and David from New York for supporting this fine podcast by becoming Hepcats. If you enjoy listening to this podcast every week, I urge you to check out supportswing.com and consider becoming a Hepcat yourself. No pressure. Just check it out when you have a chance. But David, William, thank you again. I really appreciate it.
La 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 la
So let's get this episode back on track with a medley from Marion Hutton and the Modern Airs called I've Heard That Song Before. This is also from Mail Call, which was an Armed Forces radio program very similar to Command Performance. You're listening to the Big Band and Swing Podcast.
With a medley of the best-known songs, here's Marion Hutton and the Modern Airs.
From an old familiar score, they always bring back memories.
We'd like to sing them again,
and you'll remember just when
you've heard these songs before.
Couple of jiggers of moonlight and at a star, four in the blue of a June night and one guitar.
Mix in a couple of dreamers and there you are.
Moonlight cocktails are the thing.
Don't sit under the apple tree with anyone else but me.
Anyone else but me.
Anyone else but me, no, 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 don't sit under the apple tree with anyone else but me, till I come marching home.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H.
I got a gang of real flippers.
I'll make my bid for that freckle-faced kid I'm hurrying to.
I'm going to Michigan to see the sweetest gal in Calabasas.
That was Sun Valley Jump by Glenn Miller. That version included Ray McKinley, the Crew Chiefs, and all the other great talent that was in Glenn Miller's Armed Forces Band. We also heard a medley from Marion Hutton and the famous Modern Airs. Up next, we're going to listen to a clip from the 1950 educational film, What to Do on a Date. Now, this film, it never won any Oscars. But hey, when is true artistic brilliance ever concerned with petty things like awards? In this scene, we meet Nick and his friend Jeff. And we also meet Kay, the young woman that Nick has a thing for. But enough from me. I'll let the film's narrator get you up to speed.
This is a story about what to do on a date. It begins one early summer afternoon. It begins with Jeff and Kay and Nick. Of course, you may not have a problem about what to do on a date, but Nick, well, he has a real dating problem. If he took Kay out on a date, what would they do? Where would they go?
Hey, what about asking Kay to come to the community center with us on Friday to fix up that scavenger sale? We could make it a double date.
That's no place to take a girl on a date, helping to fix up the scavenger sale, is it?
Why not?
Well, Kay's a swell girl. I was thinking of calling her. Maybe ask her to the show Friday. Good picture, wagon train.
Well, hurry up and call her and let's get going. I still have to get my things yet.
Call her now?
Sure. You know the number, don't you?
Okay. What if she says no?
Hello?
Oh, hello, Kay. This is Nick Baxter.
Oh, hello, Nick. How are you?
Fine, thanks. Say, Kay, next Friday, would you like to see Wagon Train at the movies?
Oh, I'm sorry, Nick. I suppose you've got your mind made up to see it?
You've seen it? She's already seen it.
Well, ask her about the scavenger set. Go ahead.
Kay, you wouldn't want to help get the scavenger sale ready at the community center, would you?
Oh, I've been hearing about that. Yes, I'd like to very much.
You would? All right, I'll call for you then. About 7? Bye. I sure didn't think she'd go to a place like that for a date.
You know, you better think some more, fellow, about what to do on a date.
Do you think she'll have a good time? What do you suppose I'll have to do?
That phone call is pretty cringe, huh? I'll play another scene from that in just a bit. First, let's listen to Frank Sinatra with Aren't You Glad You're You.
Every time you're near a road, aren't you glad that you got a nose? And if the dawn is fresh with dew, aren't you glad you're you? When a meadowlark appears, aren't you glad that you've got two ears? And if your heart is singing too, aren't you glad you're you? You can see a summer sky, or touch a friendly hand, or taste an apple pie. Pardon the grammar, but ain't life grand? And when you wake up each morn, aren't you glad that you were born? Think what you've got the whole day through. Aren't you glad you're you? Summer sky, or touch a friendly hand, or taste an apple pie. Pardon the grammar, but ain't life grand? And when you wake up each morn, Aren't you glad that you were born? Think what you've got the whole day through. Aren't you glad that you're you?
With summer, all that I feel for you. But what good are phrases? The thought that amazes is you love me, and it's heavenly. Forgive me for wanting you so, but one thing. I want you to know I've loved you since heaven knows when. There I said it
things together. Pretty good idea for a first date. Plenty to do, plenty of people to talk to. But let's see if Nick and Kay are enjoying it.
Say, Kay, are you really having a good time?
Of course I am. I'm glad you thought of coming here.
Yes, it was a good idea to come here. Hey, what's this? A list of coming activities. A bike trip. That could be a lot of fun. A chance to do things with a group, to get acquainted. It does look like a good time, if your partner likes it.
Thank you.
Bunny Berrigan with Kiss Me Again. That was from a 1938 broadcast from the Paradise Restaurant. We also heard There I've Said It Again from Vaughn Monroe, as well as the legendary voice of Frank Sinatra. And we also heard a small sampling of Nick and Kay's First Date. Great stuff, huh? You can catch that whole film on the Swing City Radio website, or just look up Things to Do on a Date 1950 on YouTube, and I'm sure it'll come up in the results. But you know what? I'm in the mood for some V-discs. Let's listen to three in a row to finish off today's episode. We're going to hear Count Basie's Kansas City Stride, Stan Kenton's Southern Scandal, and Woody Herman with Red Top. All three of these are from V-discs. And I just want to take a moment to say thank you for listening. You can reach me anytime by emailing me at swingcityradio@gmail.com. And don't forget to check out supportswing.com as well. And I will see you next time with some more great music. See you soon.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for listening to the Big Band and Swing Podcast. And hey, don't forget to subscribe and leave us a 5-star review. Also, if you want access to all types of bonus content and podcast extras, then consider supporting the podcast and becoming a Hepcat. Just visit patreon.com/swingcityradio or swingcityradio.com to learn more. If you'd like to email me your comments, questions, or would just like to say hello, you can email me at swingcityradio@gmail.com. The recordings played on this podcast, to the best of my knowledge, are considered public domain. The recordings have been cleaned up, edited, and touched up only to increase the enjoyment for the listener, and I do my best to credit the performers during the podcast. Please email me with any copyright concerns. I take great care to only use recordings, song versions, and other audio materials that are considered public domain, but I am only human, so let me know of any issues. The Big Band and Swing Podcast is brought to you by SwingCityRadio.com. Thanks for listening, everyone.